I'm Eddie Muller, welcoming you to another detour down TCM's dead end street, Noir Alley. Now, a couple of weeks back, we brought you a tidy little thriller from the B unit at RKO, Armored Car Robbery. Today, we're returning to what I call the House of Noir for another film starring one of the genre's great tough guys, Charles McGraw. It's Roadblock from 1951. In McGraw's two other leading roles at the studio, Armored Car Robbery and The Narrow Margin, he played an incorruptible lawman. Tonight, he crosses over to the dark side, playing an insurance investigator who tumbles hard for a gorgeous and avaricious dame, your textbook femme fatale. Up to a point. You'll see what I mean. Now, McGraw had steadily worked his way up to leading man status following years of film work as brutal and taciturn hoodlums in some of the era's best crime movies, The Killers, T-Men, Border Incident, and a bunch of others. Whether he was a cop or a crook, McGraw loomed as a genuine threat to anyone sharing the frame with him. In fact, the threat is another sensational B he made for RKO, which I'll be showing later this year. Although today's film was released before The Narrow Margin, that film was actually made first. As I explained when we screened it a few weeks ago, studio boss Howard Hughes loved The Narrow Margin. So much he wanted to remake it as a bigger movie, switching out McGraw for Robert Mitchum in the lead role. Now, while the film was in limbo, McGraw's mates in the B unit pulled an old script out of mothballs, sort of a consolation prize for the actor. It'd give him his juiciest, most complex role to date. The original story, called Walk a Crooked Mile, until Columbia Pictures released a picture with that title, was written by Daniel Mannering, who under his pen name, Jeffrey Holmes, wrote the source novel and final script for RKO's greatest noir, Out of the Past, from 1947. Mannering was a one-time newspaper man and private eye from the San Francisco Bay Area, who began his Hollywood career in the publicity department at Warner Brothers. His talent for fiction was revealed in a series of terrific hard-boiled novels he wrote in the late 1930s. His synopsis for what would become Roadblock was written in 1948, and he based it on the true story of postal inspector Joseph Fahey, who in 1924 knocked over a mail car for more than $2 million. Now, RKO was obviously hoping Mannering would come up with something equal to Out of the Past, but it remained unproduced, perhaps because it bore a little too much resemblance to Double Indemnity. Eventually, it was given a once-over by journeyman B-movie scribe George Bricker, the man responsible for the worst-titled B-movie of all time, Universal's 1945 mystery, Pillow of Death. When it was decided McGraw deserved another lead role following his sensational, if as yet unseen, performance in The Narrow Margin, veteran scripter Steve Fisher was hired to craft something suitable from the dormant project. Now, hammering out final drafts on deadline, that was the writer's forte. Although he was an outspoken critic of the industry's common screenplay by committee process, Fisher ended up having a long and lucrative career on many such committees, first with studio features and later on television. Not bad for a guy who'd made his bones as a penny a worder writing for the pulps. I'm willing to bet that the unexpected curveball this story throws us in its third act was Fisher's handiwork. And you will see why later this year when we show The Hunted, based on an original Fisher screenplay. Both films offer an intriguing spin on the standard issue femme fatale. Joan Dixon is our femme fatale du jour. And if she seems like a cross between Jane Russell and Faith Demiurge, well, that's not a coincidence. Like those women, Dixon was another of the seemingly endless conga line of brunette starlets groomed for glory in Howard Hughes' personal harem.
Who'd you match for the Silver Foxes?
Believe it or not, I bought them myself. With my hard-earned money.
Hard-earned?
Easy on the sarcasm, honest Joe. I have a perfectly legitimate job. Modeling.
She'd made her film debut with a couple of B-crime mellers, Bunko Squad and Experiment Alcatraz, both released in 1950, before making five, count them, five low-budget westerns opposite Tim Holt during the next 2 years. Now, in the midst of that run, she was plucked off the prairie to make this film, which 67 years later remains her finest hour and 13 minutes on screen. Shot on a minuscule budget of only $200,000, which is camouflaged brilliantly by the sensational cinematography of Nicholas Musuraka, here is beefy Chuck McGraw getting tenderized by sexy Joan Dixon in Roadblock.